Morning, everybody. Today we will be discussing about the p block elements, that is boron family. So let us discuss the elements. Let us talk about the elements of this group. Boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium are the members of boron family. Among us, the elements of this group, aluminium is the third most abundant element found in the Earth's crust after oxygen and silicon. Talk about the general characteristics, physical properties of boron family. The electronic configuration, that is the elements of the group 13 belong to P block of the periodic table, and these elements contain 3 electrons in the valence shell. Therefore, their valence shell electronic configuration is NS2NP1. So here you can see boron, the inert gas is helium, 2s2 2p1, aluminium, the inert gas is neon, 3s2 3p1, gallium is argon, 3d10 4s2 4p1, indium, krypton, 4d10 5s2 5p1, thallium, xenon, 4f14 5d10 6s2 6p1. We can see here from the aluminium onwards, the entrance of the d orbital start taking place, that is availability of the d orbital start taking place, and because of this inert pair effect and shielding effect takes place. You know that a shielding effect of s is more than p, more than d, more than f. So this will help us to know the properties in a better way. Let us talk about the atomic radii and the ionic radii. Atoms and their ions of group 13 elements have smaller size than those of alkaline earth metals of group 2 due to greater nuclear charge of the former group than the later group. Atomic radii increases on going down in the group with an abnormally at gallium. An unexpected decrease in the atomic size of gallium is due to the presence of the electrons in the d orbital, which do not screen the nucleus effectively. The ionic radii regularly increases from boron to thallium. The density, when we talk about it, decreases regularly on moving down the group from boron to thallium. Melting and boiling points. Melting and boiling points of group 13 elements are much higher than those of group 2 elements. The melting point decreases from boron to gallium and then increases due to structural changes in the elements. Boron has a very high melting point because of its three-dimensional, that is isohedral structure, in which boron atoms is held together by strong covalent bond. Low melting point of gallium is due to the fact that it consists of only Ga2 molecules, and gallium remains liquid up to 2273 Kelvin. Therefore, it is used in high temperature thermometry. Ionization energy. The first ionization energy values of group 13 elements are lower than those of corresponding values of the alkaline earth metals due to the fact that removal of electrons is easy in former case. P electrons, then in later, then in S electrons. The removal of P electrons is easy. Then in S, then compared to alkaline and the boron family. Boron family can remove, is able to remove one electron from the P, is easier comparatively to remove the S electrons from the family. This results in increase of nuclear charge. Consequently, the valence electrons are more tightly held together to high ionization energy. This first ionization energy is to remove only the P electron, which is very easy. But to remove the electron from the S, that is pair electron, becomes a little difficult. Second ionization energy definitely becomes higher. On moving down the group, ionization energy decreases from boron to aluminium, but next element gallium has slightly higher because of its smaller size compared to aluminium. Then it again decreases in indium and increases in the last element, that is thallium. The irritability observed in case of gallium is due to the ineffective shielding of the nuclear charge because of the intervening of the d electrons, which can cause an increase of in nuclear charge leading to high ionization energy and small size. Inert pair effect. It is the reluctance of the S electrons of the valence shell to take part in the bonding and occurs due to the ineffective shielding of the NS electrons by intervening D and F electrons. It increases down a group, and thus the lower elements of the group show lower oxidation states. Boron and aluminium show an oxidation state of +3 only, while gallium, indium and thallium show oxidation states of both +1 and +3. As we move down the group, +3 oxidation state goes on decreasing, and the tendency to have acquired +1 oxidation state goes on increasing because of the inert pair effect and poor shielding effect. Stability of +1 oxidation state follows the order of gallium less than indium less than thallium. Thallium in +1 oxidation state is more stable than in +3 oxidation state. Complex formation. Due to their smaller size and greater charge, these elements have a greater tendency to form complexes than the S block elements. Nature of compounds. The tendency of formation of ionic compounds increases from boron to thallium. Boron forms only covalent compounds, whereas aluminium can form both covalent, that is anhydrous aluminium chloride, and ionic compound, that is hydrated aluminium chloride, because when anhydrous aluminium chloride is hydrated, the hydrogen energy released is sufficient to overcome the ionization energy of aluminium. Gallium forms mainly ionic compounds, although anhydrous gallium chloride is covalent. Chemical properties. Some properties are given below. Action of air. Crystalline boron is unreactive, whereas amorphous boron is reactive. It reacts with air at 700 degrees centigrade as follows. This boron reacts with oxygen to form boron oxide, nitrogen to boron nitride. Aluminium is usually stable with oxygen after an oxide layer is formed. It first forms an oxide layer on the outermost surface to give aluminium oxide. After that layer is formed, further reaction with air is not possible. Thallium is more reactive than gallium and indium due to the formation of unipositive ion, thallium ion. Reaction with nitrogen. The elements of group 13 form their corresponding nitrides with the reaction of nitrogen. These nitrides undergo hydrolysis with steam and evolve ammonia. So whenever boron and aluminium, they are forming a nitride. And boron nitride, when it is treated with, you're getting as orthoboric acid with the liberation of what? With the liberation of ammonia. Action of water. Both boron and aluminium do not react with water, but amalgamated aluminium does react with water, evolving hydrogen gas. Gallium and indium do not react with pure cold or hot water, but thallium forms an oxide on the surface. Reaction with alkalis. Boron dissolves in alkalis on fusion and gives borates. Aluminium and gallium dissolves in concentrated alkalis on heating and form meta-aluminates and gallate respectively. So you can see the reactions with respect to the formation of borates, sodium meta-aluminate and sodium gallate. Reaction with carbon. Boron and aluminium form carbides with carbon on heating. Aluminium carbide is ionic and forms methane with water. While boron carbide is covalent, having a molecular formula B12C3. And is very hard and hence as an abrasive. Hydrides. Elements of group 13 do not combine directly with hydrogen to form hydrides. Therefore, their hydrides have been prepared by indirect methods. For example, boron, that is diborane, is prepared by treating boron trifluoride with lithium boron hydride. Boron forms a number of hydrides which are called borenes with the general formula BnHn+4. Borons catch fire in presence of oxygen with the evolution of heat energy. That is, you can see here, diborane on reacting with oxygen liberates -2008 kg/mol. Borons are hydrolyzed by water as follows. They are hydrolyzed to give orthoboric acid. Borons are quite stable, but the stability of hydrides of aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium decreases on moving down the group because the strength of the metal hydrogen bond decreases with increasing size of the element. The structure of diborane, the simplest boron hydride, that is BH3, does not exist as but its dimer B2H6, that is diborane, having the following structure. You can just look at the structure. So what is the explanation related to that? In the above structure, boron atoms are in sp3 hybridized. There are 6 boron hydrogen, out of which 4 are alpha and 2 are beta. So you can see here, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 are alpha and 2 are bridged. These are axial and bridged hydrogens. So terminal hydrogens and bridged hydrogens. So this is the thing, and behaved rich hydrogens. So they are having the terminal hydrogens or the normal alpha hydrogens are two centered two electron system, whereas the bridge hydrogens are three centered two electron systems known as banana bonds. So you can see over here the banana bonds formed between the bridge hydrogens over here. So this is the structure of diborane. Aluminium forms a polymeric hydride of general formula AlHc3 taken x times, which decomposes into its elements on heating. Boron, aluminium, gallium form complex anionic hydrides like lithium boron hydride, lithium aluminium hydride, etc. due to the presence of vacant p orbital in their outermost shells, which accepts electron pair from H minus ions. XH3 plus H minus, you get XH4 minus, where X can be boron, aluminium, or gallium. Oxides. Except thallium, all the elements of group 13 form oxides. General formula M2O3 on heating with oxygen. Thallium forms thallium oxide, Tl2O, where it is more stable than thallium 3 oxide because of inert pair effect. A boron oxide, aluminium oxide can also be prepared by following methods. The hardest aluminium, that is alpha aluminium oxide, which is stable at high temperature, resistance to hydration and attack by acids, is called corundum and is used as an abrasive, whereas aluminium oxide is known as activated alumina and used in column alpha, that is gamma aluminium. Alpha is known as corundum and gamma aluminium is known as activated alumina. Hydroxides. Amalgamated aluminium reacts with water and forms its hydroxide. However, boric acid can also be prepared by the reaction with the boron oxide and water. Nature of oxides and hydroxides. Boric acid is soluble in water, whereas all the other hydroxides are practically insoluble in water. On moving down the group, there is a change from acidic to amphoteric and then to basic character of the oxides and hydroxides of group 13 elements. Preparation of halides. All the elements of boron family except thallium, which forms thallus monohalide, form trihalides. All the form trihalides except thallium. Only thallium form monohalide. All the boron trihalides and aluminium trihalides are covalent, whereas except aluminium chloride is ionic. Exist as only monomers and later as dimer. Boron is existing as a monomer, whereas aluminium usually exists as a dimer. Because boron atom is too small to coordinate with the four large halide ions, and in case of much smaller fluoride ion, the energy released during the formation of bridge structure is not sufficient for the cleavage of typically P5 bond in BF3. You can see boron is existing as a monomer, whereas aluminium is existing as a dimer. BF3 is colorless gas. BCl3 and BBr3 are colorless fuming liquids, whereas Bi3 is a white fusible solid at room temperature. The covalent character of trihalide decreases on moving from gallium to thallium. Hybridization of boron in boron trichloride is sp2. Nature of trihalides. Trihalides of group 13 elements behave as Lewis acids due to having a strong tendency to accept a pair of electrons. Relative strength of Lewis acids of boron trihalides increases in the order BF3 less than BCl3 less than BBr3 less than Bi3. The halides of group 13 elements behave as Lewis acids and are acidic character decreases as follows. That is, boron is greater than aluminium, then gallium, then indium. BF3 and anhydrous aluminium chloride are used as catalyst in Friedel-Crafts reaction. Thallium chloride decomposes to give thallium chloride and chlorine gas above 40 degree and hence act as an oxidizing agent. Whereas thallium bromide converts into a complex at room temperature. While thallium iodide is an ionic compound containing thallium 1 and iodide ions, I3 minus ions. The halides of boron exist as monomers while aluminium exists as dimer. The oxides and hydroxides of boron are weak acidic while those of aluminium are amphoteric and those of the elements, other elements are basic. It does not react with steam, but other elements decompose steam. And also, let us talk about the anomalous behavior of boron. Boron shows anomalous behavior as compared to the other members of the group due to the following reasons. It has a smaller size in the group. It has a high ionization energy. It has highest electronegativity in the group. It does not have any vacant d orbital in the valence shell. A few points of differences are, it is a metal while other members of the group are metallic in nature. It shows electropy as crystalline and amorphous while other members do not. It has the highest melting and boiling point among the other elements of the group. It forms only covalent compounds where the other members form both ionic and covalent compounds. It forms a number of hydrides which are quite stable while those of the other members are less stable. These points we have already discussed. It can be oxidized by concentrated nitric acid where aluminium is passive due to the formation of oxide layer on the surface. So the diagonal relationship when we talk about so boron has the diagonal relationship with the silicon. Both boron and silicon are non-metals. Both are semiconductors who do not form ions of B plus 3, Si plus 4. Both boron and silicon forms covalent hydrides, boranes, that is B2H6, B4H6, silanes, SiH4, Si2H6, etc. respectively, which catch fire when exposed to air. B2H6, that is both are form covalent and volatile halides with fume in moist air due to the release of HCl fumes. Both form solid oxides which are acidic and dissolve in alkalis, forming borates and silicates respectively. Both react with electropositive metals and form binary compounds which yield mixtures of boranes and silanes on hydrolysis. Both boron and silicon forms hydroxide, boric acid and silicic acid respectively, which are weak acids. Boron hydrides or boranes. Boron form hydrides of the type BnHn plus and BnHn plus 6, which are called boranes. The preparation of diborane has been mentioned. Properties: all boranes are compounds of electron deficient compounds because boranes never completes its octet. On reaction with water, boric acid is formed. Borax or sodium tetraborate decahydrate. Preparation: it occurs naturally as tinnicle in dried up lakes of Sri Lanka, USA and India by the boiling of mineral calamanite with a solution of sodium carbonate. Above reaction you can get that. Properties: its aqueous solution is basic in nature due to hydrolysis. On heating with ethyl alcohol and concentrated sulfuric acid, it volatile vapors of triethyl borate which burn with a green edged flame. Action with borax bead is used for the detection of colored basic radicals under the name borax bead test, in which on heating borax bead combines readily with a number of colored transition metal oxides such as cobalt, nickel, chromium, copper, manganese, etc. to form the corresponding metaborates which possesses characteristic color. Basic radicals of the salt, copper, iron, cobalt, chromium, nickel give blue-green, brown type of color. It is used in making optical and hard glasses and the borax bead test. Boric acid or orthoboric acid preparation: by treating borax with dilute HCl or dilute sulfuric acid by passing SO2 through a mixture of powdered mineral calamanite in boiling water. Properties: it is a weak monobasic acid. It does not act as a proton donor but accepts a hydroxyl ion, that is, it behaves as a Lewis acid. With alcohol and concentrated sulfuric acid, it gives triethyl borate. With NaOH, it gives sodium metaborate. Okay, heating action is given. Uses as an antiseptic and eye lotion under the name boric lotion and as a food preservative. Structure: it is a layered structure in which planar BO3-3 units are linked H with hydrogen bonding. Boron halides. Preparation: by the action of boron and halogens at high temperature, BF3 and Cl3 are gaseous, BBr3 volatile liquid and Bi3 is a solid at room temperature. These are covalent in nature and act as Lewis acids. The decreasing order of the acidic strength already discussed: Bi3 less than BBr3 less than BCl3 less, sorry, Bi3 greater than BBr3 greater than BCl3 greater than BF3. Borazine or borazole or triborane triamine. It is colorless liquid having a six-member ring of alternating B and H atoms. It is also called inorganic benzene. It is prepared by B2H6 as follows. The P electrons in the borazine are only partially delocalized. It is much more reactive than benzene because there is an retention of partial negative charge by nitrogen atoms in borazine. It is isostric, presence of same number of atoms and electrons with benzene. Uses of boron. Boron fibers are used in making bulletproof vest and composite material for aircraft. The boron 10 isotope has high ability to absorb neutrons, and therefore metal borides are used in nuclear industry as protective shields and control rods. The main industrial application of borax and boric acid is in the manufacture of heat resistant glass, glass wool and fiberglass. Borax is also used as a flux for soldering metals for heat scratch and stain resistant glazed coating to earthen wares, and as a constituent of medicinal soap. An aqueous solution of boric acid is generally used as a mild antiseptic. So this is what we discussed for the group 13 elements as a part of the topic